We're at a particularly interesting crossroads in the development of quantum mechanics from a theory that really started off with radical ideas, both in science and in philosophy. And what's particularly exciting now is we're entering an era where it may become the mainstream technology that changes information processing, both the way we store and process information in the world around us.
I think most of society is not aware of the potentials, the great potentials that quantum information sciences could have in their future lives, in their real world. So being able to actually have a dedicated time where we can communicate and make people aware of the power of quantum information sciences, and especially for me, my interest, the quantum computing, is going to be a great opportunity.
I feel Berkeley Lab is uniquely positioned to make progress where it might be very difficult in any other kind of environment.
Since the 1930s, Berkeley Lab has led large-scale interdisciplinary science by bringing together big teams. Our distinction is the broad set of tools coupled with scientific expertise. One of our greatest assets is our scientists and engineers. It is the workforce that really drives the intellect and the spirit of quantum innovation. And that's particularly strong at Berkeley Lab.
We're all about big science and team science. And quantum information sciences, quantum computing, quantum networking, quantum sensing is a research field that needs big science, needs big teams, needs interdisciplinary teams of researchers. And that is something you will find here at Berkeley. That's what we do. We build big experiments.
We are uniquely positioned to host several large-scale DOE quantum programs, the Quantum Systems Accelerator, Advanced Quantum Testbed, and QuantNet. Because of the expertise of our staff and the resources that we have available.
At Berkeley Lab, we have the Advanced Light Source, where we have developed, as part of the Quantum System Accelerator, a magneto-ARPAS capability that allows us to really look at the fundamentals of quantum materials. Our focus is on finding ways to build the best next generation quantum computer. And we use three different technologies for that: neutral atoms, trapped ions, and superconducting qubits. But it's not just about the fundamentals of qubits. It also is about how we can build systems that potentially can scale. We have more qubits that we can control, the bigger size problems we can solve.
At AQT, we optimize the full stack of quantum computing hardware, starting from the fabrication of the very chip itself at the nanoscale, packaging it, placing it within cryogenic instruments that are wired up to reduce any external noise, and then running the classical hardware alongside of it to execute a quantum algorithm. We are looking at what are the most interesting problems in quantum information science where current hardware can be used. We're also looking at more efficient ways and algorithms to process the information at hand. And in particular, we're looking at how do we operate in a noisy world? Do we need to fix all the errors or only the most significant ones? These are critical questions in my mind that are needed to actually push the field forward and bring the hardware from the floor of the laboratory to the factory.
There are QIS experts here that know the physics, that know the materials, that know the computing, the algorithms, the theoretical side of QIS. And it has been great to take all that aspect of knowledge and bring it together on the project that I'm working on, which is QuantNet, which is about quantum communications. And what I mean by quantum communications is distributing entanglement across a fiber, across distance, between two entities. In our case, the two entities being two ion trap quantum computers. Now we are building this whole experiment from the ground up, including a new way to build the ion trap quantum computers, building quantum frequency conversion to move these photons at telecom frequencies across fiber, and using actually pre-existing fiber laid in the ground to move it between Lawrence Berkeley National Lab and UC Berkeley.
Our partnership network also supports this research. Through all these programs, we use our collaborations with universities, industry, and other federal labs to advance our science goals and develop the next generation of quantum technology.
But the real impact would come when we get answers to questions that we have been asking for a while and have not been able to do it in a quick and efficient manner with classical computing. And I really truly look forward to that result in the next decade.